Thunder MMA here, Cage Warrior 62, the Metro Radio Arena in Newcastle, with winner by TK over Dan Hope, Tommy Quinn. First off, I think I might understand why you might have wanted to single collar lock up and exchange blows in the middle of the ring, mate. That power was on show for everybody.
Ah, thank you very much, man. I've been doing a lot of training. I've been coming back and forwards from Belfast and Newcastle for this camp, because my tenancy ran out over here. So I've been doing a lot of boxing with a former pro boxer, Damien Denny, up in Belfast in Rooney's gym. So he's brought on behind power a lot, I feel, you know. And then coming back here, between having his knowledge and the knowledge of Davey Patterson back in Ireland as well, and my original coach, Emma McNally, to come over here to the likes of Peter Irvin, my coach, and all the other lads from NEVT, you can't not progress, you know. And especially with opening of the new Bad Boy training center in Felling just this previous week, it's going to be something else.
Again, you know, is that the type of fight that you expect and want? Did you want the stand-up war, or were you quite happy to take it where it needed to go, if it needed to go anywhere else?
It's mixed martial arts. You have to be prepared. Obviously, you're going to have a position you want to favor yourself, you know. My tendency tends to be to strike. I like to strike. I was expecting Dan Hope to maybe come and tie me up against the cage, because I've seen him do that in a couple of previous fights, for what I've seen previously. So, but he was happy enough to stand and trade, and so I was happy enough to do that. That's what my intentions were, and thank God I got the TKO. You know,
both of you got chins on you. I mean, were you? I mean, he took some heavy, heavy shots before they called it. Were you surprised at how tough his chin was, or was that what you expected?
I wasn't expecting to be as tough as that. I thought he'd be a bit gun shy, to be entirely honest, because I've heard from previous people. But he has a tough chin. I hit him a couple of times, and he shied away, and then he came back with right hands and that. So I had to keep me. I had to keep active and alert at all times, you know, because, you know, we're at a good level now. Everybody's just thereabouts, the very top levels, you know. It's just getting the wins, and lucky enough, I got a good win against a good opponent.
I mean, you did land some heavy shots towards the end of the fight before he sort of went to ground. Could you sense the finish was there for you?
Yeah, once he started to shy away, I thought, yeah, now I'm starting to land. I didn't throw as much of my jab as I'd like to have, but lucky enough, as I say, I got the finish, and I'm more than delighted. The 15-minute curse is over. Thank God.
I got to say, you know, when you're standing next to a fighter that is thoroughly pleased with themselves, and well, you deserve to be. Is there anything you take from this that you need to work on? Is there anything that you take from this win that you want to apply in your next camps?
Well, I'm very happy how comfortable I felt in there tonight. You know, we generally have a quite familiar and comfort with fighting in a cage. And that's quite obscure compared to the amount of fights I've had, because I don't, compared to a lot of guys, don't have much experience, especially the likes of Dan Hope. I think he was 10-5 coming in, and this was my 7th pro fight, you know. But I'm lucky enough I have a comfort level, and I was dead happy the way I dealt with the pressure he was coming forward, the pressure I was putting forward. Obviously, you want to see the footage sometime next week or the following weeks. I'll be disgusted at some of the things to do, you know. You have to be hypercritical in this sport, otherwise you'll not get better, you know. We're too harsh on ourselves, but we need to be.
I have to ask about the open challenge. I have to ask about the letter. Yeah. That was probably one of the cleverest pieces of social media usage that I've seen a fighter use in a long, long time. Was that why you did it? Or were you being honestly genuine that that's what you wanted?
Honestly genuine, that's what I want. Because the thing is, it is an entertainment business, you know? And the reality of this sport is not everybody makes it to the big levels, you know? And I'm super aware of that. That's why I've got my degree to fall back on if MMA doesn't go accordingly. So the reason I wanted that is, if I don't make it to the big levels, I want to be able to show my kids, if I'm lucky enough to ever have kids, that's what I used to do. And I want to have something to be proud of, you know? Like, any person can go in and fight and just try and grind out a win. That's not a fight for me. I want to go in and just throw down, have a good fight, because that's what it is, a fight.
This is going to sound like a stupid question, because of course the answer is, yeah, I want the win. If that had been a 3-round fight of the night kind of war, would the result matter as much? You seem very sort of, not laissez-faire, not complacent, but you seem very relaxed and you're not putting a lot of pressure on yourself to go out and get all the W's in the world, because you could become a boring fighter and lie on someone and win. Where does that come from?
Me personally, you know, like, as I said, I want to put on entertaining fights. I want to go out and it's entertainment business. I have a lot of friends here. I don't want them to come over. It's the wrong time of year. It's Christmas. People are paying a lot of money to come to these shows. So I want to put on a good fight, you know. And if it means me coming home with a few black eyes and that, I'll be happy with that.
you don't need to worry about having put on a good fight. That was a phenomenal performance. Look, I know you've got to go for medics, and then you've got an army of people that want to see you. Before we let you go, is there anyone you want to give a shout-out to, any sponsors you'd like to thank?
I'd like to thank my sponsors, Bad Boy, Alpha Boys, Nootropics Supplements, and also Smuggling Duds. I have all my training partners for it's helped me through this. There's too many to name with any VT lads. I've already mentioned all my coaches. Without them, we're nobody. We're just as good as our own training partners. So I'd like to thank everyone who's ever sparred any round with me. It's all aided to what I've become, you know.
Sorry, it was a pleasure watching you work. It was even more fun meeting you in person. I look forward to seeing you fight again. Congratulations on a fantastic job.
Thank you very much, sir.
A pleasure, all the sir. Best.